Okay, I think I am streaming. Let's see. Let's check it out. Game is loading. Let's just see if I've got the stream going properly.
You know, if you want to know how much money did I make, join Discord. I will reveal it today. Please don't bubble beam me and swap.
Okay, I've got a little technical difficulties going on here. Just trying to get to my home. The game is loading. Farming Simulator, No Man's Land. See what's happening. Yes, I am streaming. Okay, so the game is now live. All right, welcome to Farming Simulator 22. This is No Man's Land by Alien Jim, and I've set up a nice farm here, which I really enjoy working on. And let's just do a little tour of my farm. This is an older game that I have set up. And I really, really like. So here's the main house. Circular driveway, and let's start out by going to the right. On the right hand side, you can see one of the fields I created, one of the sheds, all of my greenhouses. So one of the things I'm doing on this particular farm is that I'm doing all of the Let's go around the corner. So we start at the very beginning of the farm, right here where my grass field is. And actually I may do, oh, it's almost 16 to 26. Let me slow down time a little bit. That's not slowing it down, that's speeding it up. Let's slow down time to 5 minutes. And so here is the farthest end of the farm. I have a grass field on the right hand side. And here on the left is a field where I'm going to plant, what are you doing here? Wheat. I'm going to plant wheat here on this field. Now we're going to come around this side. Check out this side. This is, like I said, it's going to be my wheat field. That field there in the distance is going to be another wheat field. So I've got two wheat fields going. Or I shall when I plant. And we come over this hill. There are two chicken coops here. See, do I need to pick up eggs? Eh, not right now. My rock crusher so that I can get some fertilizer. What is that stuff called? Lime. I couldn't come up with lime. So that's this side of the farm. We can keep coming over this way. This side of the farm is, here are all of my other sheds. You see a lot of sheds. And usually I drive over here and park. And then go inside and get my tractors. So as you can see, there's several sheds here. For this playthrough is that this is an established farm that was inherited, and the farm, as you can see if I show you, is way in debt. Look at that, $1,335,000 loan with $272,000 in the bank. So the whole idea I have for this playthrough when I created it is that this is an already established farm, and the person who inherited it now has to turn it into a money-making farm, get rid of all the debt. So as you can see, there are my tractors, some all of the kinds of equipment all over the place. Oh, I forgot to show you, here is my combine. Got a combine in there. Forage wagon. Forager. And I've got my mower. So all of this is available already on the farm. I've got all the equipment needed to get things going. Cows. We got cows. Silage pits. Plenty of silage. Here's another one of my fields. Got corn growing here, which I'm going to turn into silage. So what I'm going to do is take the silage out of here and start hauling it. Get a little money for that. Slurry pit. Another cow barn. Let's see, yeah, I probably need to put some silage in here. And now I'll show you the factory and the town. Excuse the fire trucks in the background. Somebody's burning something down. Now we come this way. Right here is my sugar beet field, and the sugar beets are growing nicely. Come around here. This is where I had oats growing, which I think I'm going to plant oats again. And come around here is where all the factories live. Sugar mill, the grain mill, the dairy, and the bakery. See anything ready? No. But there is some, what was that, chocolate? I think there's some chocolate right here. Yes, there is. Oops, almost ran into it. Is that chocolate or is that fire? No, that is chocolate. So, what I'm going to do with the chocolate is put it into my cold storage. Sorry, I use this mod. Oops. Doing a bad job, but that's okay. Because I hate trying to deal with the forklifts and everything in this game. So, sorry I cheat that way. don't like that, I apologize. But now I'm going to put the chocolate in cold storage. This little shed right here is my cold storage. Open cold storage. There we go. Now I keep all my cold stuff until I'm ready to sell it. Now just pretend. Now you can't really see any cold, any way that this is cold storage. Just pretend. But this, I think I just loaded a mod that actually has a cold storage in it. But I don't want to buy that right now. I don't have a lot of money and I need money to do stuff with. Now as soon as we get to the point where chocolate is at a peak, I'm going to sell all of this chocolate. Check that right now. Let me check the price of chocolate and see if now is a good time to sell. I don't think so. I think I passed it. I think I'm There it is, chocolate. Okay, the best time to sell chocolate would be this January. So right now I'm in August. The price is depressed. Nope, not selling my chocolate now. It's not a good time for that. Oh, well, what I did want to look at is the price of sugar. I've got a lot of sugar. Like right now is a good time to sell sugar. Oh, the prices are going up on sugar. The highest was $9.54, and we got $9.54 right there at the farm shop. So this would be a good time for me to sell some sugar. So let's do that because I'm going to have so many. Oh dear. So this is going to be a good time for me to. Oh, and there's my town with a bunch of sell points in it. We'll go over there, but I want to go ahead and get this sugar sold before it gets too late. And I lose the prices. So let me go get a tractor and go get my. Now, don't say anything, because I am, now I could get the auto loader, it is true, and do auto loading, but I don't feel like it, so, sorry, not gonna auto load. Let me just close these up. Like my yard looking neat. Actually, I can close that because I'm not using that tractor. I'm going to use this one. You know how songs get stuck in your head? I have that Baby Shark thing stuck in my head because a little kid was playing it over and over and over. So I keep hearing. Oh man. So annoying when that happens. go and get some sugar. Sugar, baby. And celery. Now, I could get an auto loader. That is so true. But I'm not. I'm going to use the super strength and pick up all of those crates, pallets rather, and put them over here. Because I like the game to be fun, and I don't find it fun trying to load these pallets onto anything. Just don't find it fun. So, in order for me to enjoy doing this, I'm gonna do it that way. It's cheating, they can say, but whatever. Whatever. And even to make it even worse, I'm not even going to do it neatly. I'm just gonna throw it on there. And I want to get this quickly done so that I can take it before I lose the good prices. As you can see, my sugar piles up. Soon we're going to have another harvest of sugar beets, so I don't need a lot of sugar beet hanging around. Okay, that's good. Let's go take it to where? The farm shop. Has the best price. Let's go take it to the farm shop. I'll go through the town to give a little tour of the town that I set up. Going through town. I want to put more houses, like little private houses. I just didn't get around to that. I just have this few on the left hand side. But there's the lumber mill on the right. The supermarket over here straight ahead. Come around this corner, there's the little shop. What do they call this one again? The sweet shop. The Italian restaurant. Some office storefronts. The pizza shop. This is the farm shop, I think it's called. And then over here is the fast food restaurant. So here's all my sell points. The other thing I haven't put in yet is a biogas. Sell point. Now let's just go do this, sell off the sugar, and here we go. $6,679. So that was a nice haul for sugar. I could have probably done some more. I have so much of it. But I think the next thing I want to do is silage. To sell some silage. Clear the silage pit so that when the corn is ready, I can put some corn silage in there. The sun is setting. Sun's about to set on the farm. Actually, let's see how much more sugar I have there. Because I may take some of it and put it in the bakery. See how much there is already filled up. Let me see if the bakery needs any. So we'll look at our production chain. The bakery doesn't really need sugar. I think I'll sell some more. Let's see what are the prices for sugar. Still, it's $9.54. Let's sell some more sugar. So I have to have somewhere to put all of the sugar when I do the harvest for my sugar beet. As you all know, that sugar beet equipment that I'm going to have to lease is expensive. Past the sugar beet field. Got some stuttering going on for some reason. It would be cool if we had traffic lights, or there may be traffic light mod. Just to put up a traffic light or a stop sign. No, there should be stop signs. I have to look for stop signs. I can put some stop signs on my roads. Go sell some more sugar. Another 6679. So that's what, over $13,000 you just made in sugar. Very good. That'll help pay for the equipment that I'm going to have to lease to harvest the next batch of sugar. So it's getting dark now. I don't like trying to do any work in this Okay, and especially this map when it's dark, because it is, you can't see anything, it's just pitch black. So I'm going to go park the tractor. And everything, tomorrow's gonna rain. I'm gonna go park the tractor and get in the pickup and go back to the house, and it's gonna be the end of the day for this particular, it's gonna be the end of August. But I'm done for today. Storage place, garage. Like I said, I'd like a neat yard with all the equipment put away where it belongs. Oops. Pickup needs to be washed. See, can I reach from here? Yes, it can. Here's a pickup, a quick wash. Sleep until morning. Left the front door flying open. What kind of thing is that? I like the inside of this house. What's the farmer going to have for dinner? Pizza! Pizza. I would think if you're on a farm and you have access to all this freshly picked vegetables and so forth, you might not just be eating pizza. You could cook up something really good, but anyway. So let's sleep until the next day and see what else we can get into. Okay, so it's now September 1st and we're officially in autumn. Okay, so let's see, what are we going to do now? So let's see what needs to be done. Okay, so it's time to plant the wheat. Time to plant the wheat. And really that's all we have to do is plant the wheat. So let's get to that. It's wheat planting time. The fields should all be ready. And now it's just a matter of planting the wheat. Look, deer. Come, deer. Let me pet you. Let me pet you. No, don't run. Don't run. Come back, please. I don't know. They always run away. I don't understand. I'm just trying to pet it. Oh, well. Well, anyway, let's go get ready to do some planting. And it's a beautiful September morning. A good time. time to put some wheat in the ground. Hot air balloons are flying in the distance. It's very picturesque. Here, I'm going to get the big deer. So for this, we're going to use the 9470RT. Planting it's in good condition, so let's go in here. So all the rest of our equipment is okay. Open this door since I'm going to haul it out this way, I think. Okay. I love these nice big sheds. Plenty of room to walk around and park things in. I have a face in the other side. Oops. I did not see that until now when I just tried to pick it up. But the front of the thing is in the other side. Oops.
Oopsie.
Make sure we have the right. Oops, this is the wrong one. That is not the one I want. Oh, okie dokie. That is not the one I want. This is some real professional farming going on right here. I don't even know which planter I want. Oops, didn't mean to click that button. Clicked that one by mistake. No, actually I did have the right one. Okay, sorry my people. I'm really confused today. I'm very confused. That was my bad. I did have the right one. I saw sugar beet, and I'm like, this can't be the right one. But it is. I thought it was. Hey, my bad. Let's go plant some wheat into the ground. You didn't see that. You did not see that. Well, actually, I should say I shouldn't play weeding. I'm going to use a worker. That's right. I'm going to do this one row. Then I will put a worker on it. Because at the end of this row, there are some rocks. Usually there's a problem. Okay, so we're going to turn on the cedar. We're going to lower the cedar. And start. Just make sure everything is working out the way I want it. So it's going to need fertilizer. Oh, don't I have fertilizer in here? Yes, I do. Oh, that's right, because there's no fertilizer on the ground at all. So now I have to put the fertilizer in. Two passes. Turn this around. Put a worker. Because I wasn't exactly straight. I'll have to come back and fill in this little space up here that I missed. That's that. And the worker should be able to... Well, not an object. The worker should be able to finish this whole field with the amount of seed it has. I think. And I think I have it set so that the workers are not going to use seed, because I slurry you have, and I'm going to turn that off. So I want to make sure that I use, it's cheaper for me to put seed in there than to let the worker do it. So while that's happening, I'm going to walk back and get the truck. Oh, wow, I've got a lot of... I've got a lot of strawberries. So I think I'm gonna have to change the strawberry... Well, let me pick up the strawberries. Now I'm going to have to pick up the strawberries. And so get them sold. And again, my apologies. Because I'm going to use super strength. My cows. Actually, I've been meaning to put some trees in there so the cows have a place. So they can have a little shade in the heat of the day. Keep forgetting to do that. Because I want them to be able to shade, get themselves some shade and not cook in the heat of the day. But they have a whole barn that they can go into if they're hot, really. I'm gonna get some strawberries sold. What's worse is not only am I using the super strength, I very rarely even put these things on here in a nice fashion. I usually just throw them on. I'm being neat about it because people might be watching. People might be watching, so I'm going to be a little neat. But normally I just throw this stuff up there. Selling a pile of strawberries. Because I don't think the bakery needs any. I'll check, but I don't think I need any in the bakery. First of all, there's not a lot of storage for strawberries at the bakery. The storage is a little minimal. So I don't think there's room to put many more strawberries in there. See, I have a lot of strawberries to sell. I got all of these greenhouses because this was the first time I was going to be using the bakery and I wasn't sure how many strawberries I was going to need. That's why I put in so many greenhouses. Plus, when you think about it, greenhouses are just so cheap. they're very cheap. They pay for themselves in no time. So I always, oops, I'm doing this badly. So I always like to get. As many greenhouses as I can afford. Because they're so inexpensive. You know, I think they're $10,000. And if you sell your strawberries like I'm doing here, getting the optimal price for them by hauling them myself. As opposed to having them directly sold, I'm gonna make top dollar on these strawberries. I'm a little too close, that's a problem. Sorry, I got distracted. And so, oops. And I think I put these a little too close together. So even if I was going to try to use a forklift or something, I didn't give myself enough room between these greenhouses to even use it. That was my bad. Because I was just trying to optimize space. I wasn't really thinking about getting the pallets off. He's still over there going, or she. She's still over there going, doing that planting. Keep an eye out for if the worker runs out of seed. Think so. Nope, still going. I think the worker has enough. To finish that field, and then I'll put more corn. Then I'll put more seed is what I was supposed to, oops, what I was supposed to be saying. I'll put more seed and then the other field will get done. Then I'll have plenty of straw. Plenty of straw for the cows. Which is a good thing. Yeah, I have no shortage of anything. I've got plenty of everything. plenty of everything. So I think I'll do the other two greenhouses in the next one. I've got that one and the one in the distance. Let's see if I can, so nothing falls off. Okay. So let's go bring these. To look to see who I'm selling this to. So the strawberries are going to go to, let's see who's giving us the best price for strawberries right now. See, this is the best. This is not even the best time to sell. This is when the prices are very low, but it doesn't really matter because they constantly are producing. But right now, like usual, the farm shop almost always has the best price. They have $4.25. Since I'm selling these things off season, or I should say off peak price, I'm going to go ahead and take them to the farm shop. Liters of strawberries going to the farm shop to be sold. Work is still working. Still going to have to put another layer of fertilizer. On the field. And I'm good with that. So we can get the yield as close to 100% as possible. See how much we get for these strawberries. $3,826. The best time to sell them, but strawberries aren't something that's going to keep forever. I mean, it's bad enough I have those cakes in there, but I'm only keeping them till now, and I'm going to look at the price for the cake and see how that's looking. Something satisfying about driving a tractor. I'd like to someday drive a real tractor. Is it still going? Yes, it is. I'd like to do that one day. Spend a day on a farm doing real farm chores. That would be lovely. I think I will try seeing how the auto loader works. When I'm done streaming, I'll check it out. That way you just don't have to sit and watch me badly stack these things onto this trail. It can happen really quick. But believe me, I'm sparing anybody that watches this any torture of seeing me try to do this with a forklift or with a front loader. No. That would be... I mean, you might find it entertaining when you see the struggle and you hear the swearing, but I don't think that makes entertainment. At least it doesn't entertain me. This I can do and I don't mind. Next section. This section might have a lot waiting to be removed because sometimes I don't take the strawberries from this one because it's far away. I get lazy, I admit it. So it may have more to pop out. Maybe. That's semi-decent stacking. Semi-decent. And if I wasn't, I could have really tried to just do it all and stack one on top of the other, but nope, didn't feel like that. This is the easiest thing. And that's it. Strawberries are now moved. Nothing falls off as I'm driving. And here we go. It's amusing the way those chickens fly and go running across the coop. Did stuff shift? Did something fall off? No. It did! I know! I knew something was falling. Stay on there and behave. Something was wrong. Let's go sell our strawberries. Back at the farm shop. And then I think by now the worker... Yep, the worker has completed their task. And I'll go move on to the next one. The next task. Listen to the birds chirping. Hold. See how much we get for this batch. $2,549. Okay, so that's like $6,000 earned from the strawberries. It's a nice pile of money. All of that is needed. This is needed. One game that I'm looking forward to, Kingdoms and Castles, the update, the finalized of the update they're doing with rival kingdoms and all that kind of stuff. That is the next game I'm going to play. I'll probably stream some of that because I really like that game. Really like it. Some Kingdoms and Castles. Now I may not be very good at that game, I admit that. There may be some problems in my gameplay, but wow, I didn't realize that was so bumpy right there. Let me see. Let's see if I can smooth that out a little bit. Move that. Do a little landscaping. See, did that help? So right here that there was a big lump. It's still very lumpy. I wonder why that is. Alright, well, we'll deal with that later. Let's go over here. This tractor. Oh, didn't start it. Over the top of this hill, because there was this section here that I missed. I just hate having missed spots on my field. So we're gonna put more seed in. This is not enough to finish that next field. Our top is flooding over. It's not enough to finish this field, so I'm gonna get some more seed. I didn't really need the fertilizer, but fine, put it in there. I just need to see. So let's go plant. Time I'm going to put slurry in the field, because I should have plenty of slurry to put the next phase of fertilizer on these fields. I should have enough slurry. Thank you. just like to check. Make sure everything is working correctly. Okay. Go ahead, worker. Do your thing. Right now, the worker's going to deal with that. Going to run back to the other tractor. To look into getting some silage taken care of. Can I do eggs? Let's see. What are the prices for eggs right now? It's gonna really peak next month, so. Yeah. It's rum still. I mean, is that realistic that eggs could sit out like that? No. They would need to be refrigerated, but what can I tell ya? I should get one of those storage units with the refrigeration and put it over there. For the silage, I think I needed to buy the other piece to the to this thingy here. Yes, I do. I think last time I leased it because I didn't have the money to buy it. But I think I'm good with money right now, and I can buy the other piece to this, what do you call that thing again, the conveyor belt, and start moving some of that silage, because if we look at the calendar, the corn is going to be ready to harvest. I'm going to have to harvest the corn and the sugar beet. So let's go to the store and get that piece for the conveyor belt, the piece that I don't have. I'm going to buy it instead of leasing it this time. Advantage of leasing over buying. Excuse me. Is that first of all, I won't have to haul it all the way back here. And second of all, in the long run, it'll save money. To the dealership. Hello. I'd like to buy a piece of conveyor. Okay, let's see. There is that again. Belt system. So I have this piece. this the piece I need? Or is it this piece? It's this piece. That's why I didn't. Well, let me see if there's anything on sale. What do they have on sale here? Yeah, nothing. Nothing useful. Which is usually, which is usually the case. There's very rarely anything there that's useful for me. Excuse me, throat is getting dry. Yeah, so this is the piece I need. It's $38,000. Got it. Thank you. Thank you, miss. Sorry, it's allergy season. This is the piece. If this is not the right piece, I'm going to be very upset. But I think it is. My apologies for the cough. I may have to stop and go get myself some water. This is cool. I love using these conveyor belts. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the conveyor to fill the trailer, dump whatever can fit into the area for the cows, to sell that silage. I wonder if now's a good time. I didn't look at the price on the silage. I should have been watching that. But I wasn't. So sorry. Get off the grass! I'm gonna run on the grass. Bring this over. It's noon. Oh, while to figure out how to work these conveyors properly. Yes, Moomoos, I hear you. Get this. First of all, let's take the cover off this. There we go. Worker silo is open. How did this go again? Let's drive this in here. That into this. Move it back a little. Now get this piece and drive it over there. Want to raise it. Is it this? No. Oh, unfold the belt. And lift this up. Now let's get that. It may not be high enough, but we'll see. Let's get this thing. Oops, smashed the cart. Come over here. Turn the conveyor belt. Think. Me in this one. Okay. Oh yeah, that. There we go. Got it. Fill that with silage. We're going to give some to the cows. And then what the cows don't use is going to get... Process is still going. The silage is flowing. Silage is flowing. Delicious silage to feed. What do I have? 120 cows. Workers still working. Let me see how much silage is selling for. Man, this is not the best time to sell it. Not at optimal pricing. Okay. Okay, moves. I've got a big pile of silage that I'm going to pull into your, things in the middle of making silage. Oh, there it's done. Oops. That's always fun to watch. Watch the robot. There he goes. It's going in. They have plenty of silage. I don't know why you're putting more there. What, am I in your way? Seriously? You've got plenty of feed. Look at them. Look at all that feed waiting for them. Get them chowing. Hey, moo-moos. Chow down, moo-moos. Give me milk, moo-moos. Put as much silage there as can fit. Maybe all of it. Oh, looks like all of it is gonna go in. Oh, okay. I didn't realize all of it was gonna go. Well, let's get some more. Let's get some more because we have plenty. Too far away. going. Fill her up. Fill her up. Silage. Fill this one up. Because I'm going to fill both of the cow auto feeders with silage. I'm going to fill both of them up. And then what's left will get sold. Because once I put all that silage in there, it'll be a while before they need more silage. A long while. And then I'll be able to, when that corn is ready next month, take that corn and turn it into and put it in the bunker. Well, even though I have this empty bunker, I really don't have to empty this bunker. Maybe I will. Since I have this bunker that's available where I can always put silage. So let's put this in. Make sure the cows have plenty of food. Oh wow, it's gonna take this whole thing also? Huh. Wow, I'm surprised. I'm surprised this thing could take all of that. $78,579. I can't believe it filled up a whole nother wagon full of silage went into that thing. Silage is going to go in. Okay, so I underestimated how much silage could fit in those cow barns, in those auto-feeding cow barns. Obviously, it can fit a lot. this. Okay, I've got plenty of silage. Plenty. So let's go and do this. Now, if this, if the third one goes in there, then I'm going to be very surprised by how much silage can fit in that thing. This should fill it up. I would think wrong. Well, it took three loads. Liters of silage is in there. To put some in the other cow barn first before I add any more to this one. Even though it looks like I have more than enough silage. When it came to putting this stuff in there. Alright. Phew, got really warm in here. I had to, this computer's kicking so much heat, I had to put the air conditioner on. It's 83 degrees right where I have my computer. Okay, the worker has finished the task. So that's it. I've got all of my two wheat fields are now planted. Now it's just a matter of going ahead and putting on the next phase of fertilizer. I thought there was a bug crawling on my screen. That was a bird crawling up the side of the bunker. This silage on the other cow barn. So I think that one has gotten more than enough. Three whole trailers full. So let's do the other one. have to say, this is very convenient. As opposed to having to use the mixing wagon to feed the cows, this makes cow feeding so much easier. Yes, Moons, I hear you. Let's not go crazy. Oops. I said let's not go crazy. Let's go crazy. Okay. To fold it. Come on, you can do it. Uh-oh, maybe you can't do it. It's stuck on that lump. Okay, are you permanently stuck? See that. You did not see that. You didn't see that still. You're not seeing this either. Seems like it's stuck. Here we go. Come back around. Let's not crash into that thing. It's working. Silage out of the pit. It's working beautifully. I just love the animation. The smoke coming up and the silage pouring into the wagon. Now I can't wait until my cows, because I have 120 cows, but only 40 of them are actually producing milk. So my milk production is still a little skimpy. I've got newborn calves, and then I've got calves that have not reached maturity yet where they're giving milk. My milk production is still kind of slow. I look forward to the day when Giants adds baby animals, because it would be cool to actually see that I've got calves in the barn. Not all my animals are full-grown cows. And I would love to see chicks running around in my chicken coop. So I don't know what the holdup is with that, but I look forward to seeing that. Still got plenty of silage. I'm gonna go ahead and fill this one. So that means there'll be three piles of silage in each one. Know what I'm going to do next. I'm doing cake and bread in the production chain, and chocolate. I should find another product to produce in the chain. And then I like the way you see how the silage is going down. I love the animations in this game. I love the animations. It's filling up in the trailer. It's going down in the bunker. That's cool. Go put this away. Let's do something different for a change. Let's go this way. Animals. Getting ready to do the thing again. this one has 105 liters of silage. I would say probably another. We'll see. I've got plenty of silage in there. From the farm channels that I watch, all the farmers say, the silage smells good. Like I said, I would love one day to actually go to a real farm, see silage in pits and all of that kind of stuff, see the dairy cows, see the operation where the cows are getting milked. I'm going to do that one day. That's going to be a vacation. A planned trip for vacation. Go to a real working farm. See all of these things that I've done virtually on my on Farming Simulator 2017, 2019, 2022. I think that'll be fun. And drive a tractor, and even if somebody would let me drive a combine, that would be so much fun. Though, personally, I wouldn't trust me with a combine. Those pieces of equipment are too expensive to give me to play in. I have trouble driving straight in the virtual thing, can you imagine? Me behind the wheel of a real combine, which I might wreck or bump into something or turn over into a ditch. I'd be one of the only people that, how did you manage to turn that combine over in that ditch? I don't. I don't even know. Wow, it's gonna take another one. Oh, that's it. Okay, now that's full. And let's see, how much is that? Hundred and fifteen thousand liters. We'll fill that up. I think 115,000 liters of silage mixing with all the other stuff to make the total mix ration. I'm going to have silage. I'm not going to need silage for a very long time. Oh, well. I could have just. Well, I was over here anyway, so. Let me just fill it up and see how much of that goes into that one. I might just leave this silage. I might just leave it. Because money-wise, I really don't need the money right now. I could just leave this silage here. Could leave this silage right here in this bunker, and when that corn is ready, just pile it all into the other bunker, because I believe, if I remember correctly, this What I'm taking out now was what I harvested off of that same field that has the corn in it last year. I'm pretty sure that that was the same, that was the harvest from last year. Okay, so now that one is full. So I think what I'm going to do is, because once I pick up this silage, there's nowhere else for me to put it. I can't put it back in the bunker. So I'm just going to fill this up and take it to the farm shop. I know it was going in, the animation was showing it going in, but I don't like the way that looked. Alright, better. Yeah, I'm gonna fill this and just go sell it. Well, the farm shop is the only place that takes silage. Right, because I didn't put in a biogas plant. Well, that's all right. I'm gonna go ahead and sell it. Get my $300 a liter for my big wagon full of silage. I just wanted to see if I filled it up, or, yeah, it's full. Gonna do with the style. I don't want to unload it there. Not exactly what I wanted. be honest. Not exactly what I wanted. And this one keeps getting stuck on that. What I want is turn this around. That's what I wanted to do. To here. Alright, that's it. So that one is put away. Oops, I need that. And then this one, I want to do the same thing. I have to clean that up. To unload this. Oops, oh my. I want to unload back. Well, you're next to that one. Miles an hour. That's why it's ticking so long. Well, that's it. Those things are now put away. Now I'm going to go sell this silage. And then that'll be the end of this day. And we're at 2 hours and 10 minutes. I think for now that's going to end the stream. I've got some things to take care of, like prepare dinner. So after I prepare dinner, if I've got some, if I get everything I need to get done today completed, I'll stream some more. But for now, I think I'm going to have to call it quits. After I sell the silage, put all the equipment away. That'll be the end of the stream, and I've enjoyed it. Get for this. Nice. $5,567. Nice. Nice little piece of payday. Good time. I had a very good time farming today. Still a lot more to do on the farm. Two wheat fields need to be fertilized. Put away the cedar. Put away the tractor. Get everything taken care of for the day. here. Okay, that's weird. It won't turn itself off. Oh, the engine is off. Okay, great. Now let's go get the other tractor. Let's take this back to the farmyard, get it cleaned up, put away. So right now I'm finished with planting with the cedar. Wash with our equipment. So you don't want to put anything away dirty. I don't like to see the equipment all dirty. So power washer available is essential. Stuff needs painting, but the painting costs too much money. So my equipment's just gonna have to be pockmarked when it comes to the paint job. There we go. I'm not running all the way over there to get the other tractor, so we're just gonna have to sit there for today. Ow. Get hit by the door. Going to be the end of the stream. I thank everybody that watched. Oops, I forgot to shut it off. I thank everyone that watched. Hope you enjoyed my little run, my little farming that I did today, and I look forward to seeing everybody the next time. Thank you so much for joining me. I'm gonna save. Quit.